Hey everyone, so this is going to be my life update. I'm sorry where the camera's positioned. I don't have a tripod and I'm still using my phone because I'm not getting my camera until this Christmas. But I've kind of got my camera kind of like up on my kitchen shelf, so yeah, anything works, right? So a lot has been going on and I'm just over the moon excited about everything. So I really don't know where to start, but I guess I will just say that I think I mentioned that we got approved for a loan for a house, and we went last week, or actually this past weekend, we looked at 5 different houses that we liked, that I had picked out, that Devin and I had discussed, and we went and saw the houses. And the first house was absolutely horrible. The pictures on Zillow, which is the site I use, looked awesome. The house was, I think it had 4 bedrooms and it had 3 baths, I think, maybe only 2, but it was a pretty big house and it was starting at like 116. So I kind of knew in my head that something had to be wrong with it, or I mean, it wouldn't be priced that cheap. So we went and looked just in case, you know, it could be a good deal. We went and looked, and the carpets had stains everywhere. The walls were painted like crazy colors, hot pink, and then they had like a bright yellow orange kind of color. It was just they had a leaky faucet. Pretty much everything you can think of was wrong with that house. So I'm sorry. Hold on 1 second. Okay, I'm sorry. I had to. If you heard that, I had to set the pizza. I'm making pizza tonight in the oven. But anyways, yeah, the first house was just like horrible. So we didn't stay very long, and so we just left. The second house was only listed for 106, and it was okay. I just wanted to go see the actual house, not the pictures. I wanted to see like be in there and see how I felt about it. And Devin liked it more than I did, but I was like, no. So the next house was my house. The next house was a house that I saw on Zillow, and I immediately like knew that that was like the best house I've ever seen. It was awesome. It was listed for $115, and we went and saw the house, and as soon as I stepped in, I loved it. As soon as I saw the house just from parking outside, I was in love. So we went in, like, it's so beautiful. It's 3-bedroom, 2-bath, but the rooms are pretty big. They're a decent size, and the walls are painted like a light yellow, and it's so pretty. It like sets the house. It's amazing. The master bath. Oh my gosh, it's beautiful. Let me tell you, you walk in, it has a his and hers walk-in closet. Oh, it's great. I love it. So, my heart was pretty much set on that house as soon as I saw it. Devin, he really liked it, but he was still, I guess, wanting to look. So, of course, I wanted to look more too, but as soon as I saw it, my heart was set on it. So, the fourth house we went to, that house, I really didn't like it at all. Devin kind of liked it, but he agreed that it would probably not be a good idea, because I think it was listed at 125 exactly. So the last house we went to, Devin fell in love with, and it was kind of like me with my house, my third house. He fell in love with this last house. And I liked it too. It was very nice. The only problem was it was right at our budget. It was like 125 exactly. And I really didn't want to go that high. It did have 4 bedrooms. Well, it had 3, and then it had 1 that wasn't completed. So I don't know. I didn't really, I mean, I liked it, But it was right there at our budget, and I still like the other house better. So we left, and we talked about it, and we discussed all our options, and we wanted to put in an offer, but we just had to figure out which house we wanted. It was either going to be the third house that I really liked or the fifth house that Devin really liked. And we finally just came to the conclusion that, you know, they're both really great houses, and they're both, I think they're both in the same, about the same area. Sorry, I thought I heard something. It was weird. Anyway, so we just kind of just narrowed down to that the house that I wanted was $115,000, so it was a little bit cheaper, and it was still a great house. The only thing we would have to do with the house that I like is we'd have to get the carpet stretched a little bit because they were kind of bulked up just in some places, not very much, and we would have to get a fence. So, the house is only 5 years old, so we decided on the house that I liked, but, you know, I say I liked, but he liked it too, but it was just, it was, I guess, it was more me that liked it, but he liked it too. So, anyways, we put in an offer, and we put in for $113,000, and the house was listed at $115,000, so we put in $113,000. We asked that they play, I'm like so tongue twisted. We asked that they pay all closing costs, and we asked for a 1 year warranty on the house, and we also asked if they would leave their refrigerator because we would have to get one, and that's a big purchase. So, It was crazy because we put in an offer Sunday at 3, and Sunday night by 10 o'clock, I had an answer. So last night, because today's Monday, so last night, me and Devin were just laying in the bed, we were just talking and stuff, and I got a text message from my realtor, and I was like, oh my gosh, I can't open it, you open it. So I gave the phone to him, he opened it, and he was like smiling, so I knew it had to be good. So I was like, what does it say? And he handed me the phone, and it said that they accepted, except they want us to pay $115,000, not $113,000. So, we're going to get the house, hopefully, fingers crossed. I mean, they still have to sign the contract, so things could go south. But, I really have faith and I really have hope that this is going to work out. I'm really super, super excited. And I'm not sure I'll do a house tour yet, but I might. So, I don't know. what else? Oh. So I got that going on, and another exciting thing is my husband and I are getting baptized this Sunday, and he's already been baptized before, but he wants to get rebaptized in the church we've been going to because he wants to identify with the people that we're going to, the church that we're going to, so he wants to become one of them, you know? So I'm so super excited that everything's happening right here, and I'm just excited to move. If we get the house, which we're pretty sure we're going to, but just to make sure, I keep saying if, because I don't want to get my hopes up, but if we get the house and if they sign and stuff, then we close on the 15th of November, I think, and so we'll be moved in. But see, we're here at the apartment for at least till December, so I guess we would just have to slowly move everything in to our new house. But other than that, those are my two exciting life updates. I'm just stoked about everything that's going on. The Lord really, really, really has blessed us, and we have so much to look forward to, and it's just so exciting. And it's crazy to think back what a year ago was like. A year ago today, I wasn't even married. We weren't married. We were still living with our parents. And, that's just, it's crazy. And now here it is a year later and we're in our own place and we're about to move into our own house. We're buying our first house together. And, we found a great church and everything is just falling into place. And I really feel like, once all of this falls into place, I really feel like that we will get pregnant and we will have our little baby. And I really just think that maybe God is telling us not right now. Because if you think about it, you know, everything's falling into place. We're getting our house. We're getting baptized. We have a church family, a faith family. So everything's falling into place. And the only other thing that would be amazing is if I got pregnant. And I'm sure that God will come through for us. And I'm sure it's in His will that we have our little miracle baby and we raise it like two Christian people would. So other than that, that's it. That's my life update. And I'm so happy and, I'm just excited for the future. And there's really not much else I can say about that, except that I'm just stoked and happy and excited. And yeah, that's it. But anyway, thanks a lot for watching and thanks for the new subscribers. I really appreciate everything. And, I think that's it. So I guess I will talk to y'all in my next video. Bye.